part of Southampton, England. Nice safety railing here. They should have extend the tip of the bow so they can fit the auxiliary anchor over here. Like a proper ocean for Cherbourg, France, and that New York City. Ship is moving very fast. Early 20th century, more about the newest ship in naval experience, this fleet, the largest steamer in the world. RMS Canopic. Charts. We're due to see Cherbourg on the port sign soon. Right on cue. All stop. Aye aye, sir. Prepare the gangways. The passengers and mail coming aboard. Prepare for the tugs. Aye aye, Captain. Once we finish loading, we'll be off to New York. The tender ship Cherbourg is on the way. compared to gangways. Here comes the Cherbourg, named after her hometown. Right on cue. Up on the boat deck, boarding. This looks so surreal. Like a real life ship. Lifeboat drills being done on the boat deck. Boats uncovered and swung out. Passengers climbing in. They practice lowering. And it's supposed to touch the water. The test is complete, so they quickly return back to normal duties. Passengers and luggage have been mailed aboard. And the last of the mail being shipped over to the United States is being brought aboard. And that's the last of the mail. Gangway's being moved back in. Passengers are off the boat deck for the boat drill that they need to attend before we set off. Turkish baths down here. Passengers are returning to their normal everyday stuff after boat drill occurs. And the game ready to depart.
Take her to sea. Let's stretch her legs. All head fall. All head fall. Hoist the anchors. Night falls. Passengers head inside as outside temperatures drop. 4 days into 3 days. Just 4 days. I don't have to stay around out in the middle of the North Atlantic. Traveling at 22 knots. Calm. The ocean flat calm. The largest and most luxurious vessel ever built by mankind, RMS Canopic, is 4 days into her maiden voyage. About 1,800 passengers. 450 crew. By 11:39 p.m., all was smooth. Until three sharp rings rang on the quarrels as the dark object was sighted in the path of the large vessel. Despite the chief officer of Metcalfe that was hard to starboard, the ship's rudder being too small, the ship slowly turns to port. Both war titors. By 11:40 p.m., disaster strikes. Hard a port. Note the time entered into the law. Aye, aye, sir.
What is it?
I spoke, sir. I put a harder stop and reversed the engines, but she was too close. Stop engine.
Stop engine.
were all hands to stations. Passengers are crewed on life jackets. Prepare for low weight all boats.
Aye, aye, sir.
Crew works under the lifeboat. The ship went lost and banged against the plate cheery trees of the present. The chief of the captain gives the order to abandon the ship. Women and children first. They may be allowed to push them through. In order to come to more towards the light in the distance. At 12:40 a.m., the first boat is loaded at maximum capacity.
Thank you.
about. Yeah. finally has one final breath. The storm begins its final descent. Thank you.